Welcome to the Quick Tips series, where I will be sharing little tips and tricks that I've learned along the way, both working for myself and working for other composers in LA. Today we will talk about MIDI flags, which is a concept I've learned at the first studio that I worked at. MIDI flags are essentially small MIDI regions at the beginning of each track in your template. Those regions should contain all relevant MIDI data that would reset a contact patch to its desired default state. An example could be a key switch that selects the articulation that you want on that track. Another could be CC data that selects the default loudness or velocity you want for that patch. It could be CC2. Determining the default state of the vibrato, or like the squire patch, for example, that you see here, the default syllable the choir sings in is determined by CC2. In this example, CC1 is set to a value that determines which short articulation is selected by default. So depending on how you've set up your contact patches and your template, you can input anything at all to set as a default, however you see fit for your writing, for your programming, or for your mixing style. Another helper on top of the MIDI flags is putting indicators into your file names, either the key switches, or for example, a common thing I've seen is putting symbols like the percentage sign, indicating that the mod wheel is doing something important in a patch. Like, for example, controlling a filter in a synth patch or something like that. Now, why is this important? Well, first off, it's a time saver because you don't constantly have to go into your patches and select what you need to, or reread what control is doing what, which comes in handy when you have a really large template. Secondly, as you conform cues or keep composing a longer cue, things like CC data or key switches might actually get messed up. Say you have a string patch that is playing sustains at the beginning of a cue, but towards the end of the cue, you switch to shorts. It wouldn't automatically switch back to sustains when you start playing the cue from the top again. The same goes for CC data. Imagine you start out a piece fairly loudly and then you taper it out at the end, all the CC data going down. When you go back to the top, it will not default back automatically if there is no CC data in the regions. So you will then all of a sudden have really, really soft playback at the beginning of your cue when initially it was intended to be loud. So to sum it up, if you have changing CC data and changing key switches throughout a cue, if there's no CC data and no key switches defaulting back to what you had initially, it will keep reading the wrong articulation and the wrong CC data that you had at the end of the piece. This is particularly important for longer cues, for example, or also we often get a new cut and you start editing MIDI data, you start conforming a cue to a new cut, and then accidentally you cut out important CC data or important key switches that are now gone, and the cue will not play back anymore the way that you had initially intended. Generally, I would always make sure that every MIDI region has CC data and the right key switch in the front, if you use key switches, that is. But especially when you know you have to edit a lot of cues, you have to edit a lot of MIDI to fit a new cut, you know, be sure there's always CC data, there's always key switches in the right places. But even then, data can get lost and key switches can get messed up without MIDI flags. I've spent my fair share of hours working for composers, and they've made edits to their cues to conform a cue real quick, but they didn't pay attention, and then they accidentally deleted a lot of data, and then I, the assistant, would be spending a lot of hours Just restoring the cue, just making it play back again the way that we had it, the way we wanted it. So MIDI flags can really help minimize that problem for yourself, but also if you have an assistant, they would probably also appreciate that. A con to this method, because there are always cons to any method, is that you can't use certain really useful MIDI functions anymore, like show tracks with data only, for example, because now obviously there's data on every track, so that function would not work anymore. Also, before exporting MIDI files now to the orchestrator, you do have to save the session as a different version and then get rid of the MIDI flags. Because otherwise, when you export the MIDI, what will happen is every single track will get exported and the orchestrator is not going to be happy because they will be dealing with, you know, your entire template when really only so many tracks actually have data on them. So in order to avoid that problem, save as an orchestration version, clean up the MIDI, which we will get into in a different video, and then get rid of the MIDI flags because they don't need them and they really just want the tracks that have relevant MIDI data on them. That's it for the MIDI flags bit. I hope this was helpful. If you have a different way of doing things, I'd love to hear about it in the comments because this is just something I've encountered the most, but maybe there's a better solution, so I'll be happy to learn about it. Thanks for watching, and if you like this type of content, please subscribe because there's more coming.